In order to reach the achievement of having a ship sail autonomously, you are dependent on simulation. Before any ship will sail by itself, you will have to be certain of its behavior in any condition.
Well, you can imagine that the autonomous vessels that we're actually looking to develop there are quite expensive assets. And taking any kind of risk with them when they are on the water is unacceptable and is not going to happen. So that's why we need to trade extensively using the simulators to make sure that the technology and products we're taking forward are safe enough to be used on these types of ships.
So we put everything into a virtual world, into this sandbox, where we then can test all the ships, all the environment. You can put different environment conditions to it. You will test all the sensors, you will test the system itself, how it kind of react on different ships, traffic ships.
So why a simulator? Simulators are mainly used today to train personnel on board a ship, but now it will train and test on algorithms rather than humans. So how is the simulator prepared as this tool?
You have better control of what the input is and also the expected output. And if that differentiates, you can always go in and see what happens between that space, almost kind of like a black box.
We will do interface to the real systems. We will do interface to the real algorithms and do the navigation on these ships. We will do interface to the same type of sensors that you will have on board these ships. So yes, it will be fully one-to-one with what the ship will act in real life. You will do that in the sandbox, in the simulator.
Autonomous shipping has in many ways disrupted the maritime industry. New players are coming in, like Yara and Osco in Norway. They haven't been part of the maritime industry before, but because of their aim to transport goods autonomously, they are paving the way towards autonomous shipping.
I think that's the exciting thing because we have steps towards autonomy where this can be applicable to different segments. And also we see new actors coming into the maritime industry which have not been here before. So I think it's also, you see there are requirements towards emissions and being sustainable also for the existing customers in the maritime industry. But with the political influence and everything, I think these are factors which are influencing both the existing customers and also new actors coming into it. So it's a great potential for us. And it's not like autonomy is all or nothing. There are so many facets in between.